season in, and we slide right into college basketball. And you know, well, you know what, it's almost over with. The NCAA, we're about to hit the Final Four next weekend. Guess what? You know, right after that, I'm going to seek the Lord. But the NBA ain't ended yet. And then you'll find yourself watching the NBA, and you're looking to see if LeBron's going to win another one. And you know, when basketball season ends, most of us don't watch baseball anymore. It's a long sport. But, you know, we got a couple of boxing matches in there somewhere. You know, don't let it be a Floyd fight. Or a good MMA fight. So we find ourselves and we keep extending and extending and extending. And before we know it, we get trapped in the cycle year after year after year. Why? Because we've been trapped by the matrix.
That's right.
I've been there for years doing that. There are years that I've done good, and there are years that I just stank. Amen. Why? Because we're consumed with what this world has to offer. And it may seem innocent, but it's a deep, it's a dark scheme of the adversary. The adversary is entangling our minds, and he doesn't want us to seek God. He doesn't want us to do what the will of the Lord is. He's got motive in this thing. But brothers, I want to remind you of something on today. And that our God is the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. And the focus text that I read for my message on today was written by John some 1,900 plus years ago, but it's still valid on today. I came as a reminder to let you know that as a believer, we are in this world, but we are not of this world. I came to remind you on today that it's time to get back to our first love, and that is the Lord Jesus Christ. For now is high time for us to escape out of the matrix and walk in our purpose. For this world is going to pass away and the lust thereof, but he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. God is looking for some men who are willing to obey him. He's looking for some men who are willing and desiring to walk in their purpose. Not only in lifestyle, but also in our gifting. God wants us to be able to say yes to whatever he's presenting to us. Contrary to popular belief, we've got a nice audience, a nice crowd of people in this house on today. But everybody in this room is gifted for something. Everybody in this room has a purpose to fulfill in God. There is no such thing as a pew warmer. We're called to do more than just occasionally come to church and sit here and listen to a good message and declare, oh, we had a good time on today. But we are called to a life of purpose in God. I'm reminded of a statement that was made by the Reverend Bruce Williams from Louisville. And he has a statement, a slogan that he says that God didn't call you to sin. He saved you to serve. I want to admonish you on this day that it's not just a good idea to walk in purpose. But when I look at Matthew 5, 25 and 26 in relation to the talents, he said the one that hid his talent, the Lord called him wicked, slothful, and unprofitable.
Yes.
Think about that for a minute. Now that's a serious offense in the eyes of God.
Yes.
Now don't doubt we look at fornication and we look at and dope dealing and all of that. We look at those as major sins. But there are some things that God's made it very clear that he's not going to forgive. And that is one of those things is neglecting what he's put in you for the service of the kingdom. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 8 says, wherefore he said, when he ascended upon high, he led captivity captive and he gave gifts unto me. What he's essentially saying is that Jesus took away our captivity. He lived, he suffered, he bled, he died, and he rose again to give us everything we need pertaining to life and godliness. And he gifted us so we can not only be a benefit to ourselves, but we can be a benefit
Yes.
And he went through all of that. Do you think he's going to allow you to sit back on your gift and act like it don't exist? But it's time for us to wake up out of our slumber and our sleep today. And it's time for us to shake off this dream world that we've been living in for a long time. Can I tell you, my brothers and my sisters, that we got work to do on today?
Preachers like him preaching holiness no more. I remember you
came to our church years ago and you preached, right after your husband died. I never forget it, first time I've ever seen you. Preached a powerful message. And you know the substance that I remember that message? Holiness is still right.
Yes, 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 yes.
I don't know how long ago that was, probably 20 years ago, I don't know. But I remember you preached that message. You know why? Because people are wanting to go to the seeker-friendly churches. As a matter of fact, I heard Robbie Zacharias, the great Christian apologist, he was talking about a particular preacher, I'll say it that way. And he said it bothered him because he read two of his books and there was no mention of the cross. There was no mention of repentance. But guess what? He's the greatest motivational speaker on earth. So churches are being filled, but they're not necessarily being filled with the gospel of Jesus Christ. The church has lost itself in the matrix. Amen. Amen. And I said recently, I said, man, you know what? I appreciate that old holiness message.
Yes.
You know, I used to get annoyed with it. But now I appreciate it so much, right? Because of the days that we're living in, that we got to get back to some stuff. It's time for some brothers to get on the wall and begin to declare what thus saith the Lord again. Amen. I'm reminded of an individual in the movie The Matrix named Cypher. Cypher had unplugged out of the Matrix. But Cypher was dissatisfied with life outside of it. As a result, he made a deal. He's going to give up some people so he can plug back in to the Matrix. And he made a statement. He said, ignorance is bliss, as he was eating on a big, medium rare steak. So he betrayed some people. He got some people killed. But ultimately, the Cypher lost his life because he wanted to be a part of the Matrix. We've got to remind ourselves over and over again that if you're not careful, you will lose your life in the Matrix. You will lose your soul chasing a dollar, not recognizing that God's got some greater things on the horizon for you and me. He's got something far greater than what we've ever seen before. But we got to unplug ourselves from the Matrix. We can't afford to forfeit what God has placed in us. I don't know about you, but I've gone through too much to go back now. When I look back over my shoulder and I see how far he's brought me from, I would be a fool to turn my back and go back to the worldly system from whence I came. It stripped me of everything. Stripped me of my reputation. Stripped me of my resources, my finances, my time, my name. It stripped me of everything. I would be a fool to go back to the Matrix. Amen. But we want to be able to fulfill everything. Everything that God has for us to fulfill. Young people, I want to encourage you on today because you all have the capacity to reach a generation that we may never be able to reach. Amen. I'll be 47 this year. Some young folk may not listen to what I got to say, but they'll listen to you. They'll listen to you too. They'll listen to you young people in here. But God is needing somebody to catch on fire and say, you know what? But we gotta be cancer wreak havoc in our churches the way it has. Amen. I'm ready to see God get the last laugh over cancer. Somebody might have a realm of faith that we haven't touched yet and they need to step up and cast it out. Hallelujah. And that is the reason I found myself in prayer meetings recently. I had motive behind it. It wasn't just the fellowship with the saints, but I recognized I let myself get caught in the matrix. I recognized the fire and the zeal that I once had. I don't have it no more. And when Pastor sent me to that prayer meeting on that Thursday night, it stirred me up. I said, Marcel, what time y'all praying? I'm coming over here. I'm praying with y'all. And I came over here and prayed with the saints here. Went to my church the next day. I prayed with them. Why? Because I'm determined.
I want to end my life this way. He said, I've fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearing. I want that testimony. Amen. Anybody want that testimony on today? That I want to have my crown waiting for me. And I want to be able to go to sleep knowing that I have done everything my God wants me to do. Anybody with me on today? Yeah.